Welcome to the Amphenol Broadband Solutions training on the FSB Fiber Splice Boxes. In this training, we'll review the FSB features, show how to mount the enclosure, and route and install for the fiber splice tray installation and for the ribbon fiber installation. Amphenol Broadband Solutions offers fiber splice boxes that are designed for splice-only applications. These aluminum enclosures are designed for high-density splice storage with emphasis on proper fiber management, versatility of fiber port seals, and cable tie-down features. Two configurations are available, tray splicing and ribbon splicing, which accommodates a variety of splicing and patching combinations. And it is recommended that along with this video, you read the installation instructions before starting the installation. Let's take a look at the features of the FSB. Here I'm showing the FSB-A. The doors can be bolted securely and can accommodate a padlock. The doors open 180 degrees and are weather resistant. There are four mounting keyholes providing secure, stable mounting. The top and bottom have four fiber entry and exit ports with rubber grommets. There are four grounding bonding points to accommodate any bonding requirements. The FSBs can accommodate both tray fiber splicing or ribbon fiber splicing. The FSB-D has the same features as the A and has extra fiber capacity. The D can be configured for all splice tray or all ribbon or a mixture of both. There's also a plastic box option, the FSB-B. This has many of the same features as FSB-A and D, but in an economical plastic box. The FSB-B works in conjunction with the plastic slack storage box, the SSB-B. Let's go through the installation process. Locate an acceptable mounting location for the box. Place the box onto the wall while making sure it's level. Mark the four mounting locations at the keyholes. Drill four 1/8 inch pilot holes at the marks. And install the box into position and tighten the screws. In this video, we won't be covering grounding or the different entry port clamping options. For information on these items, see our videos, Fiber Splice Box Grounding and Fiber Splice Box Entry Port Clamping Options, using the QR code shown, or visit our website at www.amphenolbroadband.com. Next, we'll go through the steps for splice tray installation. The first tray position is the inner position, which is the one closest to the slack basket, with the remaining available tray positions outboard. This will allow the first tray to lay flat against the slack basket, and the Velcro strip holds it tight to the slack basket without causing it to bow in the middle. In this installation example, I'll be using the outer position to make it easier to see the installation steps. Position the fiber tray into the fiber tray tower with the hinge tab in the desired hole. Squeeze the splice tray hinge and position the tab into the hole. The fiber tray is installed and ready to be configured. The universal splice trays have two tray recesses that accept cradles. To position the cradle in the tray recess, slide the cradle in until it's engaged with the tray at the bottom. Lay the cradle flat and snap the center inboard tab of the cradle under the center tab of the tray and the cradle is installed. Check to make sure that all the tabs are engaged and the cradle is laying flat. To remove, apply pressure against the cradle until the center tab clears the tray tab. Then lift the side of the cradle up. Next, we'll route the fibers. Here I'm showing the FSB-A. When routing from ports 1 and 3, route in a counterclockwise direction. Counterclockwise routing from ports 1 and 3 presents fibers to the right side of the tray. Always route the fiber tubes behind the tray support tower and to the opposite side of the tray. Clockwise routing from ports 2 and 4 presents the fiber to the left side of the tray. If needed, an S-bend can be formed with the designated fiber tube inside the slack basket to change the stored direction. This is sometimes needed to reach the desired side of the tray. Here we're showing the routing in the FSB-D. Counterclockwise routing from ports 1 and 3 presents fibers to the right side of the tray. Always route the fiber tubes behind the tray support tower and to the opposite side of the tray. Clockwise routing from ports 2 and 4 presents fibers to the left side of the tray. To determine the cable preparation lengths for the loose buffer tube and ribbon fiber lengths, refer to the installation instructions. Let's route the fiber to the splice tray. Install the entry cable using one of the methods previously shown. In this example, the fiber is entering port 2, so we'll route the loose buffer tube clockwise around the inside of the slack basket area, and down behind the right side of the tray tower, and over to the left side tray attachment point. Remove the fiber tray cover. Mark the buffer tube at the top and bottom of the attachment point for the felt wrap location. Wrap the felt wrap around the loose buffer tube at the marked location. Use a buffer tube stripper to score the buffer tube and remove the tube. Secure the fiber tubes to the corner of the tray with the tie wraps provided. Trim the tie wrap ends. Prior to splicing, fibers can be temporarily stored around the perimeter of the tray for protection. Install a fiber tray cover. Place the document label on the cover and document the fibers. Close the fiber tray and secure it with a strap. The installation is now complete. Next, we'll do the ribbon routing. For cables entering the lower ports, 1 and 2, route the core tube up the side of the box and over to the opposite side of the bend control. Use a generous bend to avoid kinking the tube. For cables entering the upper ports 3 and 4, position the cable so the core tube extends just past the bend control bracket. Do not attach the tube to the bend control. Mark the core tube as shown, just past the metal bend control. Wrap the core tube with felt wrap at the mark. Use a buffer tube stripper to score and remove the buffer tube. Attach the core tube to the lower back bend control section using the provided tie wraps. Cut off the ends of the tie wraps. Once cable tubes are routed, wrapped, and secured, the ribbons are now ready to be spliced. Repeat the process for the second port. Measuring from the end of each secured core tube, mark and trim each set of ribbons to 43 inches in length. This will provide the proper length to twist and store the ribbons in the fiber basket area. Remove all twists in the ribbons, splice the ribbons, and place the splice into the cradles. Flip the cradle with the splices to the left, creating a cross of the ribbons. To place the cradles into the cradle adapters, place the cradle bottom edge into the bottom of the cradle adapter. Tilt the top of the cradle back against the cradle adapter and snap in using your finger. By putting pressure at the tab at the top, the cradle will snap into place. Once all cradles are installed, take the group of ribbons and flip them to the right, creating a cross of the ribbons in the opposite direction as the first flip. Organize the ribbon groups over the outer bend control locations and onto the plastic guide clips. Install four tie wraps at the outer bend control locations, being careful to contain the ribbons but avoid putting direct pressure on them. Check all ribbons to make sure they are contained and arrange as needed. Wrap any metal with felt as needed for ribbon protection. Storage of ribbons is now complete. Use the door labels needed to identify the completed splicing. Let's review what we've covered in this training session on the fiber splice boxes. We reviewed the fiber splice box features, showed how to mount the enclosure, and route and install for the fiber splice tray installation and for the ribbon fiber installation. Thank you for viewing this training on the Amphenol Broadband Solutions fiber splice boxes. For additional training topics, see our website at www.amphenolbroadband.com.